Oftentimes, the family budget is a source of conflict. Most of the time, the major earner makes the final financial decision, which isn't always a welcome deal for the rest. Since money is such an intrinsic part of family life, families need to achieve accord in this aspect. There is a four-step cycle in budgeting the family money to maintain peace and harmony. 1. Set your priorities. Priorities are different from goals. They are aspects in your family's life that you, as a family, want to set focus on, say health or children's future. While goals are specific targets that support priorities. In setting priorities, do not set too many as it defeats the purpose. Ideally, there should only be one, but because life is not ideal, 2 to 3 are reasonable. As the priorities are set and agreed upon, write them down. Post the paper where everybody can see them to remind them of what your family is focused on for the next few years. 2. List down your goals. Once the family has set and agreed on priorities, the next step is to set the goals. Goals are specific and measurable conditions that, when achieved, will support the priorities. In setting goals, establish a target that is both challenging yet achievable. A 10-15% of the family's income is a good savings target for a child's future education, stretching yet reachable. Try to limit your family into setting 1-2 goals per priority to maintain focus. 3. Work towards your goals. After setting your priorities and goals, start living by them. All of the family's activities will be geared towards working at your goals. Track progress, particularly on financial goals, by using an income and expense tracking tool. The simplest way is to get a notebook and list down all expenses and incomes and set a budget for future spending. There are those that invest in computer software or a family accountant. Whatever it is, the important thing is to have a system of monitoring the family's performance towards achieving their goals. 4. Evaluate your family life. At a certain point in time, when you feel like it's time to evaluate your life, check how your family is doing against the goals. Goals that have been achieved can be checked off the list, and new ones can be formulated. At times, in major changes, say a career move, or when a family member goes away, it may be time to re-evaluate priorities. When such a time comes, then the cycle begins, just like what it's for, life. Schooling costs. Whenever the school season is just around the corner, there's only one thing that parents are thinking about, the impending costs. Education is a primary right and a pertinent need of every child, but it can become very costly. Availing of scholarships and education grants for your children is the best way to get them through schooling. But of course, only a small percentage of children can be given these privileges. There are simple and effective measures that parents can employ in cutting the costs of their children's schooling, especially during the back-to-school season. Most often, these measures are often taken for granted, but don't miss out. Organize and save. Keep an inventory of your children's school supplies and keep it organized. If you are not organized, you will be spending more money on replenishing your supplies. Small things like pencils and crayons may not cost too much, but if you replenish your supplies unnecessarily, you are losing valuable money. You should also try involving the kids when making the inventory. This will give them a sense of ownership for their things and would know where to take and put their things. Tax holidays. Tax holidays are often offered by many states during the back-to-school season. Price ceilings will be put on different school gears. You might want to do a little research and ask about the schedule and the details of the tax holidays in your area. Bulk buying. It's a basic economic principle: the more you buy, the more you save. Well, this is applicable if you are buying a specific item which you will really need in the near future. In buying pencils, for example, you might want to buy a box rather than buying one for each of your kids. Face it, you will be needing to replenish these after some time, so might as well avail of the lower price by buying in bulk. Transportation. You might want to consider buying your child a bicycle for him to bring to school. This, of course, is not always feasible. Finding a cheap and safe way to bring your children to school daily is an important thing. Carpools and school transportation services are options that you can look at. Snacks. Whenever you have the time and energy to prepare food for your children, do so. You will not only be saving on the pocket money that you will give to them, but you are also secured that your children are eating healthy and safe meals. Getting your children through school is a hard task and a costly one. Saving money through practical and simple means can assist you in this endeavor. The benefits will eventually add up to bring a brighter future to your children. A budget is basically a money plan, outlining your financial goals. Having a budget, you can well establish and regulate funds, set and achieve your financial objectives, and make advanced decisions as to how you want your finances to function well for you. The main idea in budgeting is for you to put aside a certain amount of money for expected as well as unexpected costs. Simply put, budgeting means an estimation of monthly home expenses, basing it on previous expenses and bills. The initial step to take in budgeting is to find out how long will your compensation last. Define fixed expenses like car payments, home rental, insurance, etc. Likewise, follow up your expenditures thoroughly for a month so you can discover and understand where your funds are going. Through proper determination of your spending patterns, you can immediately identify solutions for effective budgeting. For instance, when you have a steady monthly income of $4,000, you should subtract all your identified monthly bills from that income. Other bills can be assessed and then subtracted from the amount of your income. The balance that remained after fixed costs can now be your budget in the household. Rather than allocating money for miscellaneous like gas, clothing, entertainment and groceries, financial planning will allow you instead to use proportions or percentages of it. The strategic solution in order for budgeting to be successful is inflexibility as well as flexibility. There are fixed expenses, so payment must be an inflexible factor. Budgeting will best work when very scarce omissions are made to greater limits. The idea here is to formulate goals and plans, then abide by it as much as you possibly can. Here are tips on how to budget. 1. Have good sense of money management. Your attitude is essential. Reach an agreement and compromise and know the significance of reducing expenditures. It all involves a lot of sacrifice. 2. Plan your situation. Make a listing with your earnings to one side and your overheads on the other side. 3. Know the difference between luxuries and necessities. List down what you believe as luxuries, with it, split the list in half, crossing out half the list. 4. Practice frugality but with dignity. You can have fun with little or without spending at all. Rather than going shopping, play with the kids at the beach or at the park. Budgeting is an effective and fundamental tool that is readily available to everyone. Consider it, and benefit from it. The high cost of living in today's society, wherever you may be, has made budgeting a priority among families. In today's inflationary world, nothing is more important than knowing how to wisely spend the meager income that you get. Financial problems usually arise due to lack of proper budgeting skills, or failure to keep to the proposed budget. No matter how much income you may have, it is still important to keep track of your assets and liabilities, your earnings and expenses. It is ironic, but a person who earns thousands will have the same problems with the person who earns by the hundreds. Most often, different kinds of people, with diverse income levels, have budgeting problems. Others who may have been successful in making a budget, usually fail to keep within such a budget. A budget refers to a financial plan, taking the incoming and outgoing monetary resources into consideration. A good budget should not only mean a balance or equity between income and expenditures. It also means lesser expenses, and making an allowance for savings. If you earn $1,000 per month, you should map out all the necessary expenses you will have to incur during the month, such as payment for your house, food and transportation. Of course, this is presuming that your tax liabilities have already been settled. What remains after you deduct your total expenses from your income is your savings. What you do with your savings will make a difference later on, when the need arises. You can choose to keep your savings in a piggy bank or place it in a bank where there is minimum interest rate, but at least your money is safe from you and from intruders. With a bigger savings, you can get the services of a financial advisor who can give you higher yielding investment options. Here are tips to make sure that you keep within the family budget. 1. Maintain a logbook where you can list your income and expense account on a weekly or monthly schedule. 2. Buy your groceries at one time. To do this, make a list of all the things that you would need for your target period and purchase them at one time. Sometimes, there are discounts if you buy by the dozen, so take advantage of this. 3. Avoid going to the supermarket and shops if you do not need to buy necessary items. This will keep you from making unnecessary purchases and keep you from straying away from your budget. 4. Think twice before you buy something. By doing this, you will realize that it is not really a necessity but a whim. If you are in charge of creating the family budget, chances are, you've had the unfortunate experience of having a brilliant budget plan that isn't executed well. This happens to many families and couples, and with a little attitude tweaking, you can solicit the help of your family in making your budget work. Create a family budget vision. Talk to your spouse and children about whatever budgetary constraints you are facing, or whatever financial goals you intend to set. By being completely honest about the bills and loans you have to pay, or your intention to save a certain amount of money for a family emergency fund, or a college fund, for that matter, you can help your family understand better your collective financial situation. This will allow them to change their perspective on purchases they make, and will help you make sure that whatever money-crunching strategies you utilize won't be counteracted by a subsequent spree by your teen. Another good technique is to create a list of usual expenditures per member of your family. Together, identify which items you can do away with in order to save up some extra money from your monthly income. By doing this all together, you are making your family participate better and see the contributions they can make into making your family's finances better. Should your child have the habit of continuously asking for money for minor and oftentimes unnecessary purchases, you can let your children learn to manage their own week's allowance. With their limited money to budget, they will realize the value of money. Put a cap on the amount of expenditures you make in a week. The best way to do this is set aside a fixed amount of cash that you will spend for a week. By putting this limitation on your spending, you are forced to prioritize spending on the most essential over other things. Make it easy for your family to save more. How often do you eat out? Most family budgets are blown over because of the frequency of dining out and the accompanying exorbitant expense of that activity. Eating at home will reduce your expenses, not to mention allow for your family to bond over cooking at home. Do you spend on routine purchases like coffee and newspapers? Cut back on the latte and the paper, and put aside the amount you would otherwise spend. Your family's collective saving will surprise you. Lastly, don't be afraid to create a most efficient driving route, as well as grouping together activities into one car trip. This way, you can save a lot on time and even on gasoline and car expenses. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Please leave a comment below, and click the like button. Thanks again for watching.